I want to ask you some serious questions now.
The voice of the masked militant known as Jihadi John has been scrutinized for months, every vowel, every turn of phrase analyzed. Now the world knows him as Mohammed Emwazi. This photo is believed to have been taken in 2010 while he was in Kuwait.
I said to him, yeah, go and ask. He said, no, no, I'd like you to sit.
And now an audio recording purported to be Emwazi in 2009. Voice analysts tell CNN that the voice matches that of Jihadi John.
What do you think of 9/11? I told him this is a wrong thing. What happened was wrong.
The British advocacy group known as Cage UK released this audio on Tuesday. In it, Emwazi recounts to Cage his version of events when British officials questioned him.
I said, after what I just told you, after, you know, I told you that what's happening is extremism, this and that, and you're still suggesting that I'm an extremist. And so, yeah, well, and he just started, you know, going on, trying to put words into my mouth, saying, no, you're doing this, and we're going to keep a close eye on you, Mohammed. We already have been. We're going to keep a close eye on you.
Slowly, we are getting a clearer picture of who Mohammed Emwazi was before he became the masked murderer he is today. The former headmaster of Emwazi's high school remembers him specifically.
Was bullied a little bit because he was quiet and he was reserved. But generally, he was fine. There was no issues with him. There were no massive behaviour problems with him. And by the time he got into the sixth form, he'd settled. He was working hard and he achieved great grades.
How did you first hear that Mohammed Emwazi was in these horrific videos, and what was your initial reaction?
My blood just ran cold. I honestly, even now when I hear the name, I find it incredible that to marry what I've clearly seen on the TV with the person that I knew. It literally makes the hairs on the back of my neck stand up.
For the people that knew him, it is difficult to fathom that Mohammed Emwazi is the man behind the mask. But for his family, now believed to be in Kuwait, it is a nightmare. British media, citing Kuwait government sources, say his mother recognized his voice from the very first beheading video. His father, according to the British Daily Telegraph, has denounced his son as, quote, a dog, an animal, a terrorist. Atika Shubert, CNN, London.